run video of Tina Fey by accident.
But there's one man you can never mistake because he's one of a kind, and it's Nigel Farage, the former leader of the UKIP party and Brexit movement. Nigel, thanks for joining us this morning. First, you know, Abby's been sick with the flu. Is there a British remedy for the flu that we're not aware of?
Scones?
No, I'm not. And it does seem to me, actually, when it comes to flu, that men seem to suffer or complain more than women when they get it.
I like that. That's very true.
Yeah, I think you're right
about
that.
Let's hope you two don't get it, because I'm never going to hear the end of it.
Some tea and scones would help. All right, let's talk about the Trump administration this morning and a new immigration order. There have been rumblings over the past few days, Nigel, that we could see a second executive order from the Trump administration, one that would be a little tighter legally and would basically throw things right back into the courts again. Do you see that coming?
Yes, I do, because I can't see the point of going on to the Supreme Court. It would just take too long. So I think there will be a redraft. I also think that what needs to be talked about is, you know, the judges said nobody has been killed in America by anybody from those seven countries, but there have been 72 people arrested in the USA since 9/11 from those countries on terrorism or extreme security issues. And I do think, I really do think that draft the new order and shout from the rooftops that there are people from these countries who do pose a threat.
Well, Nigel, you know, since one of the criticisms of the original order was that it took effect immediately, and President Trump said that it had to because people would try to rush in potentially before it if they knew what countries we were temporarily putting a moratorium on. Well, news has come out, information has come out about where the refugees are coming from since the order came out. So from February 3rd to February 11th, we've got a list of countries where refugees have come from, and it's staggering. Syria, 402, Iraq, 340, Somalia, 150, Iran, 115, Sudan, 37. Is this not vindication for Mr. Trump that if you give forewarning of what you're going to do, people will attempt to take advantage of it until they can't?
Well, of course that's right. But can I just advise you, be careful about using the word refugees. You know, a refugee is somebody in fear of their life because of their race or their religion. Actually, most people that are coming from those countries, whether it's coming into Europe or coming to America, are basically economic migrants. And it's mixed in with some of those that you potentially get terrorists.
So what's the difference, Nigel?
The word refugee gets misused.
Well, what is the difference?
Yeah, well, the difference is fundamental. You know, a refugee is someone like a Jewish person in Germany or Austria. A refugee is someone like an Indian who was living in Idi Amin's Uganda. They're people who, because of who they are, because of their religion, are being persecuted. And I could perhaps cite Christians in Syria or Iraq today. Just because somebody comes from a country that's got difficulties does not make them a refugee. And you know, even the European Commission, after the millions of people that have come into Europe, even the European Commission, who encourage that, even they admit that at least 60% of those that have come to Europe are economic migrants.
Well, and news this morning, too, that Angela Merkel of Germany, the chancellor, is now offering to basically pay migrants to leave Germany, money to leave.
Yeah. And that's been interesting because you remember, you know, she originally said the borders are open. Anyone is welcome here. Just a few months after that, then she said terrorism and ISIS is the biggest threat that Germany faces. And now, as you mentioned, she's
coincidence?
Saying, well, we will pay migrants to leave the country.
Well, it's very simple, isn't it? There's an election coming up in September. The German public are furious at what was done in their name without them being asked. Last week, for the first time in many, many years, she fell behind in the opinion polls. Her Social Democrat rival is now in the lead, and she is desperate to try to undo some of the damage that she's done. But as she herself admits, ultimately, this is a voluntary scheme. She set aside £75 million to do it. Frankly, I don't think it's much more than posturing. And personally, I think what she did by unconditionally opening the doors is the worst foreign policy decision, the worst domestic decision combined of any Western leader since 1945.
Well, President Trump is heading to the UK at some point this summer. We don't have an exact date on that. But he said instead of speaking to Parliament, he's actually going to hold a major rally at a UK stadium. Yeah. Well, your thoughts on that?
Well, I was asked about this earlier in the week, and someone said to me, did I think that Trump doing a big rally in Britain for military charities was a good idea. And you know what? I think it's a fantastic idea because Westminster, the Houses of Parliament, most of the liberal media here are not prepared to give Trump a fair hearing. I think if he goes out into Middle England and does a big rally, I think people would be very keen to listen. So I think it's a very good idea.
Interesting. So speak to the sort of the Brexit crowd, just like he spoke to the folks here who are frustrated at what was happening in America.
Very interesting.
Absolutely. I mean, you know, you've got your East Coasts and West Coasts who were very much for Hillary, and Middle America that was very much for Trump. Well, London was for us remaining in the European Union, but the rest of England was very much for us leaving. And they're the people. They're the people, countless millions of them, who would be interested in hearing from Donald Trump. Yeah.
Nigel Farage, live in London this morning. Great to see
Good
you. It's hard to tell how London got that idea, London fog. It's really, I can't put my finger on where that came from.
Right
behind, over his shoulder.
All right,
thanks,
coming
Nigel.
Up, is Sean Spicer's job as White House press secretary in jeopardy?